Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Hey, we just took in this nice little Salem travel trailer. This is a 2005. T25 is the model number. So with a nice little trailer with a slide out, good floor plan. You know, if you're looking for something that's kind of in that mid-size range with a, for a travel trailer, this could be a good fit. Maybe you've been tent camping and it's time to get out and get off the ground. You want to get into a trailer, this might be a really good unit for you. It has the propane tanks up front, easy to get to. This also has two batteries that are easy to access from the front. Notice it does have the little window here. This makes it kind of nice, so if you want to let in a little bit of extra, I guess you kind of need to be a little taller here to operate that or have a little step, but at least you get the idea. You tighten that down and you got a little more sunlight coming in, natural lighting. Or if you don't want that, you can just keep it shut and don't have to worry about it at all. So we walk around the trailer, you can see, notice the size of the awning. It's got a very nice large patio awning. Opens this up a lot, so you could be out here enjoying the weather, have your lawn chairs out here. The black tank flush is nice, so you can hook a hose fresh water to that and get some pressure to it, keep the black tank cleaned out in the inside. This one does have a ladder to get up on top. A little rack up there. I don't know how much you'd actually use that rack, but it's there. Check out all the storage in this. Goes all the way back underneath the bed there. So as we go inside, you'll see too that you can access this compartment from inside. Good place to store your power cord. Looks like it's got a barbecue that comes with it. Spare tires back here. Easy access to the back of your hot water heater in case you need to, for whatever reason, get to that. It's right there. You don't have to go digging around for it. Which, there's your hot water heater. Has an outside shower. You'll like that. Hot and cold water. In case you want to hose off the dogs, or maybe you're out in the sand, you got muddy feet or sand, you can spray yourself down a little bit before you go inside. Easy access to your sewer dump right there. Controls are right there handy. Don't have to look far to find those. I mentioned it does have a slide out, so you've got storage underneath the dinette here on both sides. Looks like you got a drawer inside there also that you can pull out, as we'll look at when we get inside. Good layout, pretty deep slide out. It actually adds a lot to the livable space. I like the fact it's got stabilizers on all four wheels, so you can, or on the all four corners, you can drop that down to help stabilize it when you're inside. So it's back in our detail area right now, so we haven't really had a chance to do much to it as far as cleaning. They're just in the process getting ready to do that. So you're seeing it the way we got it in. Just came in yesterday, actually. People bought a new Montana fifth wheel, so they went in a little different direction. They enjoyed this, but there was just time to for them to make a little different, go a little different direction in their RVing. So they're kind of going the luxury route, going luxury fifth wheels. Good storage in this. The sofa makes into a bed also. This is a scissor bed, so it's just going to flop out. It's pretty easy to operate. It just drops down pretty long, so even somebody that's fairly tall could be comfortable on that shelf right here with power. Good place where you could put a TV. Also, a place over here for a TV. You've got power outlets over there. Actually, that's probably what it was mainly designed for, the TV right there. We mentioned the slide out, so you got a nice dinette in the slide. These are the inside of those compartments that we looked at outside. So you've got drawers to pull out. You could actually lift these cushions off and raise up the wood that's down here too to be able to access the full top of that. But between the two, you should be able to get whatever you want inside of there pretty easily. lots of storage. There's a deep one. Kitchen has kind of an L shape to it, so it gives you a little bit more counter space. Even has an extension here. Sink cover there. You got two sinks. Pretty good size sinks, actually. Got plenty of drawers and cupboards. Three burner stovetop with a 22-inch gas oven with a broiler also. And does have a little microwave also. Looks like it's got your sound system right in here. So this one's actually going back far enough where you got a little CD player, huh? How about that? Maybe cassettes, not CDs. Don't see that very often anymore. Two-door refrigerator, gas electric freezer on top. Has the automatic feature, so when it's you have it in auto, it'll turn itself. It'll switch back and forth depending on if you have power to it. If not, it'll run off the propane side. Nice bathroom area. Sink, toilet, shower, little tub there for the little ones. Closet space. And you do have closet space on both sides of the bed. It has a walk-around bed, queen-size walk-around bed, with storage up here. The air conditioning's all ducted, so you have air conditioning ducts up above, heat down below. I mentioned that we take a look at the inside of the storage here. So there's the access to that huge storage compartment. This is nice, too, because you can slide this in and out around a little bit, so if you wanted to get to something, you can push that out of the way or bring it up close. Gives you, really you can utilize a really high percentage of that space pretty easily. Like I mentioned, maybe this is going to be your first go around with the trailer. It's nice to have two doors too. You can get in and out the back here or the front. Love to tell you a little bit more about this or show it to you in person. If you have questions, please feel free to give me a call. It's Jim Beckler, and you can reach me at 541-510-1017. Thanks.